This brings us to our third part, Bayesian decision theory. So, optimal decisions are not defined without objectives. So it's impossible to argue that some behavior is optimal unless we can have reasons for why there is a cost function that we can understand. So therefore, because they're so important, they're given different names. Now we call them cost functions. We call the opposite of the cost the utility function. We call them loss functions. We talk about expected rewards. They're just names for something that we believe should be optimized. And there was an implied assumption in the earlier parts of that, that people want to minimize the mean squared error. And we will see why that was there. Cost functions are also otherwise all over neuroscience. Now, the amount of water obtained by an animal in an experiment, the amount of food they get, the number of points undergraduates get in a game, the drug dosage, all our experiments, or a good part of our experiments, are explicitly or implicitly designed around cost functions. And arguably, evolution gives us cost functions as well. So in the case of causal inference, what did we do? We assumed that that people estimate the mean of the posterior. Why? Well, let us see. So let's recapitulate what the situation is. So we have an actual stimulus. We know about that because we designed the experiment and we write down what the stimulus is at a given point of time. This is X. What arrives in the brain is tilde X, which is a variable that we cannot know if we're on the outside. And then we have subject's estimate, X hat. Now the loss for the subject is the behavior is generally we ask people to reveal the estimate. So the loss depends on the difference between the actual stimulus and the subject's estimate. So what are the cost functions that people could care about? Now they could care about the so-called 0-1 loss function, which is if you are perfect, then great, you get a point. You win, otherwise you lose a point. It could be the absolute error, twice the size of the error, twice as bad. It could be the squared error, twice as big the error, four times as bad. Or it could be some arbitrary other function. The important thing is the loss function for such estimation problems is defined in terms of the difference between what people estimate and what the stimulus really is. But how do they matter? Well, let's look at the posterior. Here we see in green the posterior. What is it that we'd want to estimate? Now, like you can say there's the mode, which is where the green curve is highest. Is that the best estimate? Well, it's certainly the estimate that makes it most probable that we are right. But alternatively, maybe we want to go for the median of the data or the mean of the data. Now, which one should we take? And which one we should take will ultimately depend on what our cost function is, as we will see. So on a given trial, the loss is defined as the following. It's a function L that depends on x minus x hat, the difference between my estimate and what reality is. Now, can I simply choose x hat is x? Now, that would be perfect, would produce zero loss. No, because I only ever have tilde x. Tilde x is what goes into my nervous system. So what I have to do is estimate what I should believe about x and how my loss looks like, and then I can make an estimate. So how may the loss look like? So it's as before, we now have a marginalization problem. We want to calculate the expected loss, but we don't know what the right x is. So what do we have to do? Well, we have to consider each possible x all proportional to what its probability is. So that's what we have here. We have the posterior, the probability of x given x tilde, which is the posterior that we believe subjects calculate. Now we need to multiply that with the loss that would be expected if x was true. And therefore the expected loss is the integral over x of the loss that would be associated with x if we chose x hat times the probability of x given tilde x. And that's the probability here is the posterior, and then we need to integrate, no, dx, that's why we have this. So in the 0-1 loss, I think it's relatively easy. Now we get a reward only if we get it right. So the integral takes on a trivial form that only one point matters, an entire integral. So therefore, we want to go for the highest posterior probability, which is the mode. There's other losses, absolute error, squared error. So let's see what the predictions are in those different cases. So what you will now do is you will implement the various loss functions, mean squared error loss, absolute error loss, 0-1 loss, and so on and so forth. And then we will explore what's the best estimate for all of them. Please write the cost functions and visualize them.